Now let us start with the extracts today. So now the second extract is, so you have written, read the following extracts and answer the questions that follow. Okay, write down the heading, read the following extracts and answer the questions that follow. Right? So for that, first of all, first extract as we have done yesterday. Now, we are going to start with the next extract, that is day two. Aware of sun, air and water and not different from our right? So now, in this case, write on the first question. How nature is universal to us? Yes, the first question is, how is nature universal to all? Nature is universal to all. As nature is providing all the bounties equally to everyone. Okay, it is not at all discriminating with anyone, and all are enjoying all the facilities of nature in an equal manner. Okay, so this is how that the nature is equal to all. Right? Just a moment, please. Now, write down second question. Question number two for this extract. Explain the meaning of harvest and long winter storm. Of peaceful harvest, 1 minute, and long winter storm. Yes, metaphorically it is used, and moreover, which literary device is used here? It is transferred epithet. Okay, so transferred epithet is used here. So what is the meaning that the poet is contrasting here in both two? Okay, he is contrasting the situation in of, you can say, of war in the presence as well as in absence of war. In the present, in the absence of war, people used to have a peaceful life. They harvest rich yield. They are enjoying, and ultimately they don't have any scarcity of food. But during the presence of war, the effects are like winter, devoid of any happiness, or you can say devoid of any happiness, and yes, people are starving, there is scarcity of food also, and the after effects are longer ones. People have to suffer a lot because of these effects. Okay, there is shortage of, not devoid of. Okay, so the next question is, give examples from the extract given by the poet to show similarity among all of us. Or among all of, yes. physiogram, we have the same physiogram in, okay, right? Yes, our labor not different from theirs. It means that if we are putting in labor and we are getting the results, it is not like there in that case also. That they are also working hard, they are also getting the result of their labor, and ultimately their hard work is also bearing fruits. And the other examples of harvest, peaceful harvest, as well as of war, destruction caused by war, you will also explain in this extract. Okay. Write down the next extract. I'm going to drop it down. You can leave the spaces in order to write down the answers. Next is, remember, they have eyes like ours and ends with recognize and understand. Recognize and understand. So, the first question is, who are they? In the above lines, who are they? People who are across the boundaries, across the territories other than our country, okay, who are living in other territories and boundaries in other countries, whom we consider as foreigners, but actually they are not strange to us, they are similar to us, okay, in various ways. How can we win others? By strength, and their strength can be won only with love, okay, similarly as ours. What is the essence of these lines? What is the essence of these lines? So what is the sense of these lines? Remember, they have eyes like ours. Now, who wake that wake or sleep? It means that they also have the similar. Yes. Okay, they have the eyes which follow the same pattern of waking as well as sleeping. Okay. And strength, and their strength can be only won by love. It means that we all, everyone needs love. Okay. That everyone needs love. And ultimately, love by love, and in every land is common life. In every country, there is a common life. People follow the same pattern. Okay, they used to do the same type of work. Then how we are different? Actually, the poet is displaying here the quality of universal brotherhood, that we should all shun all type of differences and should come together, okay, as a single unit, that is our earth. Okay, here now. Now, the last paragraph, last extract is, it is the human earth the resultant of human actions. Yes. What is the resultant of human action? That we define it is only the human earth that we define. It means it is the human earth only that we are destroying. Okay? Okay, right? Right? So ultimately, it is the human earth which is being defiled, which is being destroyed. We are eroding innocence off the face of the earth, and ultimately, it is only we who are suffering from all this. Okay? What does hells of fire symbolize? Hells of fire actually symbolize use of arms and ammunition during war. It is the time when war prevails, and ultimately use of arms and ammunition, it produces, you can say, lot of fire and destruction, which is explained in the form of hells of fire. Why it is called as hells? Okay, it is metaphorically used for war. Why it is called as hell? Because it never develops peace. It develops only destruction, death and destruction. People have to suffer a lot, like they have to suffer in hell. So this is the reason why it is compared to that of hells of fire. Hells of fire. Okay? What lesson is delivered? What lesson is delivered by the poet?
That no men are foreign,
no countries are strange. So what it means that we are all, yes, we all are the inhabitants of this earth. We are not separate from each other. We should not develop differences. Rather, we should come together, join hands together, to consider ourselves as one unit. Okay, actually, as I have told you, that this poem is written by the poet against the colonial powers, okay, when the world war ended. Okay, so he has introduced the concept of globalization here, that we are not different. Okay, we are actually one, and we are putting in our futile efforts to demarcate, to separate ourselves, but ultimately if one part of the earth is affected, it is also affecting the adjoining as well as the other parts too. So we are trying to separate ourselves, but we are not separate. We are same. Okay. And he is delivering the message to follow the policy of universal brotherhood. Okay. Universal brotherhood. He is delivering the message. Okay. Right. Fine. Clear. So note down these questions, please. Yes, you have to do in your fair notebook. Extracts you have to do in your fair notebooks. So now just, you can say, integrated exercise, one revision of integrated exercise, okay, side by side. Okay, so I think that you should not forget about your grammar part also. So now here it is given, fill in the blanks in the paragraph, okay. So English has traveled to various parts of the world. Many words from various languages came dash part of it. It's not given anywhere. Okay, I have it from somewhere else. Okay, so because from the book in syllabus that we have done enough practice of that. Okay, so now many words from various languages came dash part of it. Write down in the rough notebook. Or write down in your fair notebooks, I'm speaking, you will give me the answers. Okay, so on the next page, write down grammar. On the next page, write down grammar. Okay, and I'm giving you, and this must be done in your fair notebooks. First is, English has traveled to various parts of the world. English has traveled to various parts of the world. Many words from various languages came. Many words from various languages came dash part of it. I'm giving you options afterwards. dash part of it, full stop, trade, immigration, trade, full stop, trade, immigration, comma, conquest, conquest, trade, immigration, comma, conquest, trade, immigration, comma, conquest, etc. are dash, etc. are dash factors that dash encourage this, etc. are dash factors. After? No, I have not given options. Came dash part of it. Came dash part. Came after came, there is a dash part of it. Full stop. Trade, immigration, conquest, etc. are dash factors that dash, that dash, put dash please, encouraged this. Okay, so now I'm giving you the options here. That dash encouraged this. So first option is, for first part, B is to be the, C option is to become, 1 minute, to become a, and D option is to become another. Okay, so now, which is the right option here to be used? English has traveled to various parts of the world. Many words from various languages came to become a, came to be the part of it, to be the part of it. Okay, so next is, trade, immigration, conquest are dash factors. So for second, the options are such, some, some, and many are some, right, some factors, which some, right, so this is the right option, some factors that dash encourage this, that. Now give the options, that first is have, second is has, third option is had, and fourth option is having. Yes, that have. Okay, that have, right, that have encouraged this. Right here now. So now let me start with the next. Okay, narration. It's to be the. It is not so appropriate. Okay. Now I'm writing some dialogues here. So give the question. Read the following conversation and complete the passage given below. Read the following conversation and complete the passage given below. First is Geeta's dialogue. Will you permit me to join dance classes? Now, mother, oh my God, The examination are approaching. The examinations are approaching. The examinations are approaching. And you are thinking of dance classes. And you are thinking of dance classes. Right? Now, to this, Geeta said, Mom, don't you remember that father advised me to relax in the evening? And dancing will help me to do that. Dancing will help me to do that. Then to this mother said, I shall speak to father about this. I shall speak to father about this. Right? So now let us immediately write down the question. Under it, Geeta asked her mother, I will give you dash, you will narrate yourself. Okay? Geeta asked her mother, put a long dash. Mother exclaimed, Geeta reminded her again dash, put long dash because you have to narrate it, full stop. She added that dancing would help her to do that. Full stop. Mother replied that she would speak to her father about it. Mother replied that she would speak to her father about it. Right? So this is the narration that you have to do. Tomorrow we will start from here only. Okay, we will discuss this part. Okay, then one more part of integrated grammar, that is gap filling, I'm going to give you. Okay, so after this, this part of integrated grammar will be complete. Okay, so that's all for today. Okay, so you have to write down the answers of these extracts as well as this part of integrated grammar in your spare notebook. And complete your notebooks for checking.